What's going on, you guys? Welcome back. Long time no see, right? Did you guys think I was gonna go back on my word on the daily uploads? Bitch, I am here. I'm ready. This morning I was like a little stressed out because I didn't know what video I was gonna put up tonight. And I will admit it gets confusing. And like, I have certain video ideas, so much like video ideas for holiday that I wanna get out for you guys. And I'm trying to coordinate which day, since this is the first time I have ever done daily uploading. But I am so happy you guys are enjoying the video so far. If you've watched my other previous videos I've had up this week, thank you so much. So for tonight, we're doing a little tea time. I'm just gonna take a bunch of questions from Snapchat, nothing crazy. But some of you sent me some real deep, intense questions this time. I feel like my tea times always get really personal with like relationship. Sometimes there's like sex questions, anything that's, I don't know, like over the line maybe, or that's just like a little racy, but I don't mind. So if you somehow are new, what's good? I'm Jordan. I really appreciate you watching and I would love to have you subscribe because like I said, I am putting out daily videos for the holiday season. So I put up a full day of eating yesterday and then also all of the Black Friday information about Ulta. So if you want to shop this Friday, at Ulta, I have a video with all the details. You can screenshot whatever deals you would like to get. So yeah, I'm hyped right now, you guys. I had worked out this morning, had two coffees, and I'm filming like three videos in total today. Yeah, I'm pumped. Oh, also showed this on Snap today as well. Look how cool this is. I'm gonna link these cases down below if you guys wanna get one for Christmas or get one for someone else. They're really cheap, and you know, I've been loving Velvet Caviar for so long. I always talk about them. But yeah, why am I being such a weirdo? Okay, but yeah, let's get into the tea time. Thank you so much for watching. You guys already know, thumbs up, subscribe, all that jazz. I'm very appreciative for it. All right, first question, interested in anybody at the moment? No, I am not. I did download Tinder, as some of you know, because I talked about it on my social media. I posted a few screenshots of some profiles that were horrible. Oh my gosh, just people having the worst manners, worst pickup lines, worst everything. I think in a Get Ready With Me coming up soon, I'm gonna talk about some of the worst messages I've got on Tinder because it's just like mind blowing. I've said before, I don't think I'm gonna like meet my husband on there or anything. I mean, maybe, who knows, but I'm just kind of on there to see what's out there. And I wanna see like if I match with someone, what is the first thing that they say? But yeah, I haven't actually been on any dates since I got out of my last relationship. I'm really waiting for someone who I can really see true long-term potential in. And then I will, go out with them, like if they ask me and it's a good match and everything. Okay, another question is about if there's any companies who I think are like shady or like scam companies who I won't work with. And you guys, this could be its own video, like a forever long topic. There's plenty of companies who have emailed me. I've checked out their products. I have not been happy with the quality of stuff at all. It is not up to par, so I haven't talked about it in a video to you. Or I think their products are too expensive. And you see lots of other big YouTubers talking about certain brands and certain products. Maybe something did work for them. Certain companies, if you guys are a YouTuber, you know this, but if you're just a viewer, you may not know this. Certain brands obviously have super huge PR, budgets and are willing to pay to get their product out there. There's one makeup brush company. I talked to my YouTube manager and she said I couldn't say the actual names of the companies because they can actually sue you. But the ending is ITY. Can I say that? It's a brush company. And they emailed me, they're like, can we send you some stuff? We'd love to work with you on a video. And I always say like, send over whatever, I'll check it out. And if the quality and the price aligns with my channel, I'd love to talk about it. But their brushes were shedding. They were super low quality, like very, very basic for the rate they were selling them for. I personally did not think that was something I wanted to talk about on my channel. So I said no to working with them. There's also a very, very popular survey site, hint, hint, that so many people have worked with. Again, if you're a bigger YouTuber and this site has worked for you and you like want to talk about it, I'm not shading anyone. Like there's so much YouTube drama going around these days. I feel like anything I say could be like taken as shade. For me, I tried out the survey site and it didn't, for whatever reason, they look for certain people in different categories about what they ask you questions about to like gather data. And I wasn't like eligible for any of the surveys. So I spent like over an hour on there and it didn't give me any points or any cash back or whatever it's supposed to do. So I said no to working with them. There's been multiple brands also going along with like shady, like scammy brands. There was a company who wanted to sue me like 2 years ago. I talked all about this in a video. They sent me a cease and desist because I tried out their fat burner and it made me so jittery. I literally thought I was gonna have to go to the hospital. I was like shaking. This was when I lived like two apartments back. If you've been an OG subscriber, you totally probably remember this. It was when I first started my weight loss journey before I found First Form. I found this huge fitness company who was like so popular. All of their Instagram, all the sponsored athletes on their Instagrams have like 6 and 5 million followers, but they're all like fake followers. You can tell they bought their following because the likes per picture are really low. But anywho, they're promoting their challenges and these products and all that. And maybe the company has changed now. Maybe it has new ownership. Maybe they're great. But I bought the fat burner. I paid like $180 because I got like the women's fat burning kit. And it did not work for me at all. I remember you're supposed to take like 2 a day. And they're, for whatever reason, my body was not happy with their fat burner. I know for a fact, after doing my research, they used really cheap ingredients to make the bundle and put the bundle together so they could sell it to the consumer at the lowest cost and they could have a crazy amount of sales and be really successful. Of course, everything is all about the profit. But for me, it did not work. I remember I literally felt like hot flashes. My whole forehead here was red. I was red right here. I had a horrible headache and I had really bad jitters. And that was when I was very first trying to lose weight and like started learning proper form and going to the gym. So I came on camera and told you guys that I had bought that because you guys were like, what products are you using, if any? So I just shared it with you. And then I came on like a week later and I said, you guys, I had the worst experience with them. Do not buy this stuff. And they saw that video and they emailed me and they said, take this video down right now. You are shaming our company. And that was, I think, like a little over 2 years ago. And I did take down the video. I will admit I caved. I was like nervous. I don't know. My dad is a lawyer. I could have reached out to him for help or like seen, I don't know what they could exactly do, but maybe they could actually sue me because I used their real name in the video. But yeah, that didn't work for me. Like if you've been on the channel a while, I have no problem telling you guys stuff that doesn't work for me or that I don't like. I'm very like upfront. But yeah, I do get companies all the time who will email me and I'll try out something and just won't really like it and I won't talk to you guys about it. The most legit companies who I have ever worked with, who I will keep working with, who are incredible, because I do have nothing like against doing sponsorships. This is obviously my job and I work really hard at it. So I'm so thankful that certain companies do want to work with me and that is how I can support Christian. ThredUp, Thrive Market. What was the other one I just had in mind? ThredUp, Thrive Market, Poshmark. And there was one other one. I mean, First Form doesn't sponsor my videos, but I have a link with them. They're one of the most genuine companies I've ever come across, and I have personally met the owner, and he is like a heart of gold. Those are companies I recommend. Their stuff is affordable. You guys love it. That stuff I'll always promote on my channel. Damn, you guys are coming in with the juicy questions today. J. Ms. Dink said, have I ever cheated on someone? No, I can 1,000,000% honestly say when I have been in a relationship, I have never cheated on that other person. I strongly, strongly believe if you truly don't have that connection with someone, obviously the mature thing to do as an adult is end that relationship and then, you know, go do whatever you please. Don't go do whatever you please like the very next morning and be like, oh, we were broken up, it's fine. No, like give it some time, wait at least until what you think is like fair or mature, but no, I would never want that done to me, so I would never ever do that to someone. All right, so I am getting a ton of questions about my teeth. I feel like I've been talking about this on Snap and Instagram story like daily, and I don't wanna like overdo talking about it, but I'm gonna do a full video in December. Anytime after the 15th when my teeth are done, because these are temporary. That's why I have a little lisp, I'm just getting used to it. I only got veneers on the top row, and I did have 2 teeth that were cracked, and my teeth were not super white, and I had a tooth extracted, and I was gonna have to pay for an implant right there anyways. So that's why it made sense for me on the top row to get it. You couldn't really tell how badly these 2 teeth were cracked unless you knew me in person and saw up close. I was never like very super insecure with my smile or anything. Obviously I've been on camera for like 3 to 4 years with it just how it was, and it was totally fine. It was not a necessity. It's just something I have always wanted to do. And yeah, I would have got the bottom row as well, but to be super honest and transparent, they're so incredibly pricey. I am on a payment plan to like pay off the top row. Like, I don't mind telling you guys that, like I can keep it real about it, whatever. And I don't know, like my bottom row, I do use my White With Style whitening kit, which I've mentioned before, which actually works incredibly well. So because the veneers are gonna be so white on top, I'll continue to use that on the bottom so that they both match. But I'll be able to give you like full details and stuff in December once I get the final ones done and they fit my mouth a little bit better. They're gonna be a little bit of a different shape and a different shade of white. So I'll be able to give you like a much better like full review then, but I am loving them so far. So all of you who have snapped me saying that my smile looks great, I really, really appreciate that because it's a huge investment. So it's really nice to hear that. Okay, another question. Hey mama, you're truly inspiring. You work so hard for what you want and you have done it all on your own. This past year, thank you so much, by the way. This past year I have tried to be like that as well and I have gotten told I'm too intimidating for men to date. What's a really good comeback for that? A good comeback is just to keep doing your thing and being successful. I love that. No one has actually told me that I'm like intimidating, but in both my past two relationships, I made as much as the other significant other or more, and I was like trying to grow my business and just do all this stuff, which I think is incredible. You guys know I'm all about other boss babes supporting other boss babes and like being a young entrepreneur, growing your empire and your business, whatever your passion is. Literally, the sky is the limit. Do not ever dumb down your talent or what you're passionate about or growing something big because you may be too much of a woman for someone else or too much of a man for someone else. That significant other should build you up and support you and want you to do great things. I know it can get a little tricky though nowadays because women are like kicking so much ass and making money and building their businesses. And in a lot of relationships, the woman is like the bread maker. How do you say this? Bread maker, homemaker, brings home the bread, brings home the bacon. You know what I'm trying to say. So hopefully if you're in the right relationship, your man would understand. And that can be like, instead of him being like, damn, she makes more than me, or she's doing more in her career at this moment, they should be like, damn, that's my boo. You go, you do it. I'm in such a weird, like corny mood today. I'm just really happy. You know, it's Thanksgiving tomorrow. I have so much to be grateful for. I'm happy right now. But yeah, don't like dumb yourself down or stop reaching for your accomplishments because you might be too intimidating for someone else. The best setback is a comeback. You guys, all my jokes today are off. Ignore me, but just keep killing it, girl. Okay, worst date I have been on. This wasn't really worst, but I had a date, I wanna say around 2 years ago, where it was a date from Tinder as well, where I matched with someone. He was really cool. We chatted for like a week or two before we met up. And he was also a single dad and he wasn't supposed to have his daughter this night. So he came and picked me up and we were gonna meet up. And then in the middle of us driving to dinner, we didn't even make it to dinner. He got a call that he had to go pick up his daughter. So I was like, oh my God, of course, do it. Like that father daughter time, I know with Christian how much that means. I'm like, you go for it. Just drop me back off. We'll meet up whenever. And he insisted for like 30 minutes. No, I'm not gonna drop you off. We'll just grab her and we'll all go out to eat together. And I was like, I felt so awkward. I didn't know what to say because I love kids. I'm so down to go like eat with, you know, his daughter, but I would never introduce Christian on the first date ever, ever, ever. And I totally get not wanting to introduce a significant other or even just someone you're dating to your kid in case they get attached or anything like that. So I was very like, no. And he only had her part time. So I was like really strict on the fact that I wanted him to cherish that time he had with her. So I was like, just drop me back off. Like we can go out some other time. He's like, no, it's nothing. Don't even worry. So we ended up going out to eat with his young daughter. And then on the way home, we went to one of those, it's kind of like at Burger King where they have like those tubes where the kids can go in and play. And it's like this huge play thing outside a fast food restaurant. I don't remember if it was Burger King, McDonald's, what it was, but we ended up stopping at one of those because she wanted to go play like in the balls and like go down the slides and stuff. So we were just like sitting on this little bench with like a little like patio thing, just talking while she was in there playing. I'm sure people passing by thought we were just like her parents and we were just like watching her, but it wasn't really like an awkward date. It was all right, but I just felt like, you know, I'm not gonna introduce Christian to someone unless it's someone I see like real long-term potential in. And I just felt like I was imposing, so I felt that. So that was kind of one of them. I also made a video on my channel, I can link it below, of my real, real, like worst date. I took this guy, okay, this guy was supposed to pick me up to go to a club. This was a while back as well. I ended up picking him up, paying for the gas. He ended up asking me on a date, but then not having a penny to his name. So I paid for all the drinks. He got super drunk. He went crazy on me and told me that he just got out of an engagement and he was like suicidal, all this crazy shit. That's a whole nother video that I've already made. So I'll leave that video down below. It's like a long story time as well. But other than that, I haven't really had any too many like crazy dates because I dated my son's dad on and off for 5 years. So that took up like all my time. And then this past relationship was only for a few months. And other than that, I don't entertain people really. unless it's like I really see potential in you, because I would just rather spend my time with Christian. Alrighty folks, this has been another very long juicy tea time. Thank you so much for participating. If you do have me on Snapchat, I always appreciate the questions, and I just love doing these like really casual chatty videos. So if you're not already following me on social media, please be sure to do so. I am launching 2 holiday giveaways, and make sure you're subscribed down below, because I really am trying here with the daily uploads, guys. I would love your support. What else? Oh, I'm having my ebook for 50% off this entire month, just in the spirit of Thanksgiving and how appreciative I am for you guys. It's literally the price of a Starbucks Frappuccino. So if you haven't thought about purchasing it, I really hope it changes your life and it can give you a full life reality mindset change, because the principles within the ebook have truly changed my life and I'm just extremely passionate about it. So I will have just my website below if you would like to check that out or purchase it like for someone else. That would just be incredible, and thank you so much. And I think that's it. I know this was a long one. I love you guys. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'm gonna see you tomorrow with another video.